really quickly, I'm going to show you how to set up a defaulted iQUBE2 to a 920i. I'm just going to be using one board with four cells, which I have simulators on to simulate the load. And I'm going to be using a two-wire 422 connection. The first thing we want to do is make sure that our dip switches are set for two-wire 422. Currently, it is not. I'm going to switch that quickly. All our channels are green. Our cable's connected. We're good to go. In the setup screen on the 920, when we drop it under scales, we're going to go right to serial. And I'm going to be using port 4 on board. It's the only one with 422. And left to iQUBE2. And at config, we're going to go right twice to port type and down and make sure 422 is selected. Press enter. Right once to config. And we're going to press our connect soft key and verify we get a serial number back. The rest of the nuns that are listed are if you had a secondary, tertiary, and a fourth IQ board. In this case, I have one, so that is a normal screen you would see. Now that we have connection, go ahead and come down to boards. If you had more than one board, you can press your auto assign key to automatically set your sequence. And you're going to be pressing the S1 setup switch right next to the power connector. The order is always going to be second through the last board, then the first. If I had two boards, I'd press the one in the second, then the primary. If I had four, it'd be two through four, then one. Second through last, then first. Once you get done, you're going to have a screen that pops up similar to this. It's going to show you the addresses for all your boards. Once you're good there, hit done, and you'll be at cells. We come under cells. I'm just going to drop under A1 here. That's my first channel, my primary. We're going to see capacity and sensitivity. Now, if you want to change the capacity of all cells at once, you could key that in here. And instead of pressing enter, you want to set assign to all. And every cell that's in the system is going to default to 50,000. I'm going to set mine back to 75K. Come back up, right to sensitivity. And this is your millivolt per volt rating. I'm not going to change mine, but it would function the same way. If it's different, you can key in a number and assign to all to change all cells at once. Once your cells are good, arrow up until you're highlighting cells. Right once to scales, come down. And by default, it's going to add in your four cells for your primary board. If you had a secondary out to four boards, you'd have all your available channels over on the left. If you skip any channels, you want to make sure not to include them. And they're just going to go in order by number. So your secondary board is going to start at 5 and go through 8 and every group of 4 from there on. If you were going to skip some, you wouldn't include the number for those channels. And then once you add them, it's going to build your map down here, showing you your scale layout. Once your scale is good, we're going to press done. Go right to your warm-up and come down. And this is going to delay your actual weighing operations by whatever number is shown. By default, it's 6, which is only for very cold regions. If temperature is not a concern, let's go ahead and set that to 0 and press enter to disable that warm up. So as soon as we power on the system, we're ready to weigh. With our configuration done, we're going to arrow up to config, push the download soft key, and choose iQUBE2 configuration only, and press enter. And it's going to say finished. And now you have shared your settings between the two and you're ready for calibration.